muzimba kuitika batana tinokunda
the life for sharing.
Tikabatana tinokunda muZimbabwe tikabatana tinokunda tikabatana tinokunda muZimbabwe tikabatana tinokunda tikabatana tinokunda muZimbabwe tikabatana tinokunda Kunda muZimbabwe, tikabatana tinokunda. Tikabatana tinokunda muZimbabwe, tikabatana tinokunda. Tikabatana tinokunda muZimbabwe, tikabatana tinokunda. Batana tinokunda muZimbabwe, tikabatana tinokunda. Tikabatana tinokunda muZimbabwe, tikabatana tinokunda. Tinokunda. Tikabatana tinokunda muZimbabwe. Tinokunda.
Hello, comrades. We are still trying to build an audience. Can you please share this video so that we build up an audience?
Tikabatana tinokunda muZimbabwe, tikabatana tinokunda. Tikabatana tinokunda muZimbabwe, tikabatana tinokunda. Tikabatana tinokunda muZimbabwe, tikabatana tinokunda.
We still have about 5 minutes. We still have about 5 minutes. I'm just trying to build up the audience. Please, can you share this?
Tikabatana tinokunda. Batana tinokunda muZimbabwe. Tikabatana tinokunda. Tikabatana tinokunda muZimbabwe. Tikabatana tinokunda. Tikabatana tinokunda. Tikabatana tinokunda muZimbabwe, tikabatana tinokunda. Tikabatana tinokunda muZimbabwe, tikabatana tinokunda. Tikabatana tinokunda muZimbabwe, tikabatana tinokunda. Tinokunda muZimbabwe. Tikabatana tinokunda muZimbabwe, tikabatana tinokunda.
Uzumba we! Gwanda we!
Tikabatana tinokunda muZimbabwe.
Wati suge we. Wati rowe we.
Kunda. Tikabatana tinokunda muZimbabwe. Tika.
Please share this so that we build our audience. We still have about 3 minutes to start.
Tikabatana tinokunda muZimbabwe, tikabatana tinokunda. Nyika inorema, nyika ye, nyika inorema. Nyika inorema, nyika ye, nyika inorema. Nyika inorema, nyika ye, nyika inorema. Tikabatana tinokunda muZimbabwe, tikabatana tinokunda.
Unity, 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 Zimbabwe.
tinokunda tikabata nati nokunda muzimbabwe tikabata nati nokunda 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 tikamuiva nodema nyika iye nyika inorema vana baba vanochema nyika iye nyika inorema nyika iye inorema nyika iye nyika inorema tikabata nati nokunda muzimbabwe tikabata nati nokunda tikabata nati nokunda muzimbabwe tikabata nati nokunda tinokunda muzimbabwe tikabata nati nokunda nokunda muzimbabwe tikabata nati nokunda tinokunda kunda muzimbabwe tikabata tinokunda muzimbabwe tikabata nati nokunda.
Yes, welcome those who have joined. Please share this so that we build up an audience.
Tichazara mote se mumugwaba Wanu awa wano manikidza masi zvaisingadi Wanu manikidze masi Wanu manikidze masi Musamanikidze masi bonda tidi musamanikidze masi Wanu manikidza masi zvaisingadi Wanu manikidza masi Wanu manikidza masi zvaisingadi Musamanikidze masi bonda tidi musamanikidze masi Tichazara moto se mumugwaba tichatose Zimbabwe mumugwa Tichazara moto se mumugwaba andaitara moto se zvasingadi Tichazara moto se mumugwaba Tichazara moto se vano manikidza masi zvaisingadi Musamanikidze masi bonda tidi musamanikidze masi Musamanikidze masi Musamanikidze masi Vakamanikidza masi
Hi Teresa Hi to Begle Yes Vicky Can you turn that one Yeah, thanks. Yes, thank you for those who have joined us. Can you take it a little bit down? Can you hear me? If you can hear me, please, can you just put a thumbs up? Yeah. Yeah, thanks. Hey, leader, promise Sunday. How are you? Take more. How are you? Maibuye is Zimbabwe. Zimbabwe Yadzoka. Teresa, thank you for joining. Yes. Okay. Yes. Yes. I can see that you can hear me. Thank you so much. Can you please share this live video so that we build up an audience? Yes. So today I'm going to deliver an end of year talk for Zimbabwe Yadzoka. Maibuye is Zimbabwe. So on the agenda, I'm going to give you progress of what we have managed to achieve so far. And then I will also end up giving our plans for 2017. Can I start by congratulating you all who are watching, the Zimbabwean people? Maibuye is Zimbabwe teams in villages, in districts and in provinces. You have been doing a wonderful, wonderful job this year. And all social movements in particular, this 2016 will go down in history as a year where people of Zimbabwe have chose to speak out against the ZANU-PF government and Robert Mugabe. And we have built tremendous, tremendous progress. And this is the progress that we wish and the momentum that we want to take into 2017. So the theme for this presentation, it's unity, 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 and unity. This is how Zimbabwe, as Zimbabweans, we can reclaim our country. Tikabatana tinokunda. Right. Yes, Evie, you are joining us. Admin, how are you doing? Zimbabwe Yadzoka, most of you, as you may know, was launched in August, on the 6th of August, in Macheke. And Zimbabwe Yadzoka, when it was launched, we launched it with 10 to 15 people were present for the launch. But it's amazing now that we are in December and Zimbabwe Yadzoka is now in 10 provinces of Zimbabwe. And we have got teams on ground in 10 provinces of Zimbabwe. And the movement has been launched in officially launched in seven provinces. And this is amazing how the people of Zimbabwe want to reclaim their country. So it has been a tremendous year where we have made a lot of tremendous progress. And I want to thank teams that are working on ground for Zimbabwe Yadzoka, the courage that you are showing every day in and out, you have been showing throughout this year, and to encourage you to take this further. Zimbabwe Yadzoka is a sub-outrun movement. Our emphasis is to focus on the rural communities because we believe this is the community, this is the population that has been excluded in the political discourse of our country. And if we can harness this and if we can give voice to these constituents, there is no doubt that we can reclaim our country. And Zimbabwe Yadzoka has taken the bull by the horns. We have gone into these places. These many places that have been called ZANU-PF strongholds. And we are getting tremendous, tremendous support. And people are getting the message across. So this is to say that Zimbabwe Yadzoka has managed to build up a coalition that is non-partisan of Zimbabweans who want to see a new Zimbabwe. Vanhu vanoda kudzora Zimbabwe. Maibuye is Zimbabwe. So with this tremendous capital that we have built, we want to take the momentum into 2017. In 2017, Zimbabwe Yadzoka will continue to go into the villages. Zimbabwe Yadzoka will continue to go to Chiendambuya. It will continue to go to Checheche. It will continue to go to Lupane, Gwanda, Mabia. These are the places that we will continue to go, to Zaka, because this is where the gospel is needed most. And these are the areas where we have to focus to reclaim our country. So Zimbabwe Yadzoka focuses on rural population, but also we focus on another demographic that is very, very important, the millennials, the youth. And this, I think if we look at the numbers, this constitute almost the majority now of voters in Zimbabwe, the below 40 population. And we are also focusing so much on this population. And we have launched a campaign called Zvimakire Zama. Decide your own destiny. Vote. And this campaign is getting tremendous support from the youth, from the young people. So what we have seen from Zimbabwe Yadzoka is a movement that is focusing on the rural population and is focusing on the millennials. And these two blocks, it's a victory in 2018. But what we appeal, what I appeal, is unity, 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 unity of purpose in anything, in everything that we are going to do in 2017. Let's do it together. The only way we can reclaim Zimbabwe is if we are united as Zimbabweans. And this is an appeal that we are making as we move into 2017. Let's be united Zimbabweans. Tikabata na tinokunda. Welcome Francis Katsua, welcome Babington. For this, I ask you to share this live video so that we get a little bit of more audience. So I appeal to us as Zimbabweans that let's be united. That's the only way we can reclaim our country back. There are so many things that divides us. There are so many issues that divides us. But when we look into the bigger picture, Zimbabwe is our country. We all love Zimbabwe. And the only way we can reclaim Zimbabwe is if we work together, if we get united and manage to build a winning coalition. This is what we have to do as Zimbabweans. So it's an appeal that is coming from Zimbabwe Yadzoka. Zimbabwe Yadzoka will continue to go into the rural areas. Zimbabwe Yadzoka will continue to target the millennials. In 2017, we have got so many programs and projects that are lined up, one of which we are going to launch what are called Ilima Nimbe as strategies to mobilize the rural populations. And we are going to do this in Mashingo. This is the province that we are going to start to launch this, and the feasibility studies have already been completed, and in January we are launching it in Mashingo. And we are looking forward for this. But we, as Zimbabwe Yadzoka, cannot do this alone. So my appeal is to other social movements. My appeal is to you as Zimbabweans that let's be united. Let's build a winning coalition. Come 2018. Let 2017 be the year that we are going to totally reclaim our country. 2016, the citizens, we have been speaking out. But 2017, let it be the year that we are going to reclaim our country. The only way we can do this is if we build a winning coalition. Unity, unity, unity of purpose as Zimbabweans. I am very, very grateful to be working with the team, Zimbabwe Yadzoka teams on ground, tremendous teams in provinces, in districts, in constituencies. And we have managed to build a coalition that is non-partisan in all these areas. So my question always is, if Zimbabwe Yadzoka, a social movement, manages to go into these areas, into these villages, and we are managing to gather people from different political parties, we are managing to build this coalition, why is it that we are always told that we can't build a winning coalition in Zimbabwe? So as we move into 2017, let's push this agenda forward. Let us know that it's only when we are united that we can reclaim our country. My sister Patricia Mrambinda is saying, yes, we are reclaiming our country back. Yes, we are reclaiming our country back. And the only thing way we can do this is when we are united. When we are united. So Zimbabwe Yadzoka appeals for unity, unity of purpose among social movements, among us citizens as Zimbabweans, and among politicians of different political parties. Because this can be done. Zimbabweans, this can be done. We can reclaim our country back. There is nothing that tells us that we can't do this if we are united. So I appeal to you, let's continue to support social movements, let's continue to speak out, let's continue to support the work Zimbabwe Yadzoka is, the tremendous work Zimbabwe Yadzoka is doing. Our teams on ground in Checheche, in Murambinda, in Binga, in Lupane, all these people are doing a tremendous job under very, very difficult circumstances. And as we move into 2017, it's going to get harder. It's going to get so difficult. But if we are united and if we manage to support these people on ground, there is no doubt that we can reclaim our country back. So as we move into 2017, my appeal to you all, my appeal to you Zimbabwe Yadzoka, my appeal to you Zimbabweans is, let's get united. Let's move beyond petty differences, because what separates us are personal agendas, are personal egos, not issues of ideology. Zimbabwe, a very small country like Zimbabwe, a population of 13 to 15 million, we are having almost 50 political parties. What ideology is driving all those 50 political parties? When country like United States of America, how big they are, they've got two main political parties. If you add with the others, probably they are about 2 to 3 more political parties, 5 political parties. But in Zimbabwe, a very tiny country like Zimbabwe, we are having 50 political parties. So my appeal is that as Zimbabweans, let's think of unity. Let's think of get united. Okay, Francis Katsua, have you talked to political parties about a coalition? Zimbabwe Yadzoka is going, our priorities Zimbabwe Yadzoka is going into the rural areas, doing these campaigns. And our coalition that we are building is of different political parties. Our representatives are of different political parties. And these are people who participate in the political processes of different political parties. So, yes, our agenda, it gets to the people. It's going to the politicians. But I think what we have also to understand as citizens is that it's also time that we need to build this momentum, and for politicians also to know and to also respect when citizens are speaking out. So this is something that is very important that we haven't been doing as Zimbabweans. But this year, 2016, I think all of us can attest that citizens have been speaking out. And this is something that we continue to encourage, that as citizens, let's continue to push politicians for this. Let's continue to push politicians for unity. Let's continue to push politicians to build a winning coalition. And yes, politicians are getting our message and politicians are getting the signals. And I think a number of discussions are going on and a number of configurations are being worked up. But as citizens, let's continue to speak out. Because when we go into these different villages, when we go into these different townships, what we see are Zimbabweans who love Zimbabwe. And these people, when they meet, they don't talk along political divide. They talk the love they have for their country. They talk the love they have for their children, the future for their children, not different political parties. So I think we need, as Zimbabweans, we need to transcend over this, to know that we are doing this for our country, we are doing this for our future, we are doing this for our children. I personally, I am a parent, and when I look at my children, the question that you have to ask yourself is that, are we going to sacrifice the future of our children for politicians who tell us that there are some divisions that we don't see when we go into the villages? Okay, so what we are building is a coalition based on people's power. Okay, so this is very important, that it's high time that our politicians have to listen to the people. Okay, and another Shupi Matenga, thank you for watching. Teresa Gibson, people's power. Yes, we need to build, we need to build a coalition based on people's power, where people have to speak out. People have to be the masters, and politicians are the servants. Sister Patricia, 50 plus political parties in a country of 15, 16 million. We need to have a coalition to defeat Mugabe. Yes, so this is what we are saying, that the fact that we are already saying that we have got 50 plus political parties in a country like Zimbabwe, it speaks volumes about us as people, that we can't work together. And this is what we need to challenge. This is what we need to challenge. We need to be united, because the political parties that we have in Zimbabwe, the differences are not ideological. It's not like if you ask their manifestos, you can see some ideological differences to be able to constitute these 50 political parties. So this is the fallacy that we need to challenge. As our politicians speak that they can't be united, let's continue to question them and to push them. On what grounds can't they be united? Because we don't see these divisions. Most of these divisions are personal divisions among our politicians. And as citizens, we cannot sacrifice our country, we cannot sacrifice the future of our children, because politicians can't sit together and discuss the future of the country. So what we are effectively doing as citizens is to give politicians an olive branch to say, 2018, this is their last chance to do this for Zimbabweans. If they are serious about about Zimbabwe, if they are serious about saving the people, they have 2018 to demonstrate that they can do this. As citizens, we will continue to push for coalition. We will continue to do that. Zimbabwe Yadzoka will continue to go into the most, because what we are doing as Zimbabwe Yadzoka is probably the most dangerous job, okay, that politicians normally don't want to do. We are going into the rural areas. We are going to Mudzi. We are going to Zumba Maramba Fungwe. We are going to Zaka, campaigning for politicians. We are a citizens' movement. We are going campaigning for them. So what the least they can do is to sit down and to talk and to listen to the people. And as Zimbabweans, I urge you, let's continue to talk. Let's continue to speak out. Whatever difference, whatever channels that we have, let's continue to speak out. Okay? Amai Tongai, welcome. You are right. There are only two political ideologies at the moment, ZANU and the people. Yes, this is very correct. This is what we are saying. Zimbabweans, we are all united now that we don't need ZANU-PF, we don't need Mugabe. This is something that is overwhelming. As Zimbabweans, we agree on this. Why is it that our politicians can't sit together and talk about unity and talk about a winning coalition so that we get rid of ZANU-PF? So what the scenarios that we may have is that we are going to have a coalition and we are going to have a winning coalition. Or we may not have a coalition, but what we are doing, we are effectively giving ZANU-PF another 5 years. And I don't know among you who among us now want ZANU-PF to have another 5 years, when we have got this beautiful chance to get rid of ZANU-PF. We have got this marvelous chance. We have started this movement in 2016. That is so beautiful. We can continue with this in 2017. All citizens are willing to engage. And I urge the diaspora also to chip in a little bit more into this. Let's speak out. Let's assist the foot soldiers on ground. Let's build some institutions or some mechanisms to support those people on ground. Because things will only get worse. With ZANU-PF, things will only get worse as we move towards election. So we also need to know that the people who are working on ground, they need our assistance. So I agree with you. We don't have different ideologies, so many different ideologies. After all, where do we get 50 political ideologies? It is just ZANU-PF against the people. And let's do this, Zimbabwe. This is a marvelous chance that we have to reclaim our country back. Okay, so Zimbabwe Yadzoka will continue to plug in. We will continue to do our activities. We will continue to carry our pungwes, our night vigils in villages. We are going to launch some nimbes, ilima, as innovative ways of mobilizing. We will continue to engage with different stakeholders, different citizens' movement as we move towards elections, and we will continue to mass mobilize. Teresa Gibson,
this is the end for them and new beginning for the citizens of Zimbabwe. Yes, Teresa Gibson, this is the beginning of the end for them, the people in power. As citizens, we are beginning to speak out, and we are speaking out loud, and I urge you all that let's continue to speak louder. Tikabatana tinokunda. Unity, let's speak unity. Anybody who is telling us that we can't be united, let's challenge them. On what grounds can't we be united? Are we trading our future? Are we trading our country? Are we trading the future of our children? Because our politicians can't sit down and speak one language, can speak unity. Okay? Ivi Mshaba, Chairman, what about the Nimbes? Zimbabwe Adzoka from January is going to launch Nimbe. The Nimbe concept, I think, as a way of mass mobilizing in the rural areas. And we are going to launch this in Mashingo. This is the province that is going to start this. And this January, so it's going ahead. And then it will quickly spread into other provinces. So we ask you, Zimbabweans, to come in and support us, you know, with these different ways of mass mobilizing in rural areas. And also as a way of empowering our own people, because we need to show to the people that there is an alternative, so that the people cannot always buy into the ZANU-PF goons. Those that they come, you know, towards elections and they are giving people some 5 kgs of rice or some 2 kgs of seeds or something like that. So let's also go there, citizens movement, and let's also start this kind of Nimbes or some kind of projects, or, you know, these social projects, to show to people that, I mean, we can also offer them solidarity, that we also care about them. So that's why we are starting this kind of projects as well, more than mass mobilizing, but also to build some confidence with our people. Okay, George Chinyau, by telling us that you are telling us again, and they, by telling us that you are also telling, yeah, okay, yes, I mean, well, we are going to launch Nimbes, and that's true. And we know, of course, when we are having this kind of broadcasting, that CIC 10 are also watching. But we are going to launch in Mashingo. Mashingo is too big. And the Nimbe is going to be launched in one village. I mean, and it's going to be done. We can't. The CIOs, they are always everywhere. There is a way that they can find out. But at the same time, we also need to broadcast to our people so that they know the progress that we are doing and the plans that we have. But that's very correct, that the situation that we operate in, or the conditions that we operate in, are always very difficult for our foot soldiers and for social movements and citizens as well. If we forward ever. Yes, Zimbabwe Adzoka will continue. We are not giving in. We will continue to plug in, and we are asking all citizens in Zimbabwe, also in the diaspora, that support us. With, you know, whichever way you can, support us whichever way you can, because the agenda that we are carrying is non-partisan. We are pushing for a new Zimbabwe, a Zimbabwe where you and I can speak out our mind, a Zimbabwe where you and I can decide our own destiny, where we don't have to wait for politicians to tell us every time what to do. The politicians have to listen from us, not instructing us as they do. So we need broad consultation on issues. And as we go around, as we consult, as we give people voices as Zimbabwe Adzoka, people are telling us that they want a coalition. So I think politicians owe this to people. People want unity. People want to be united and defeat ZANU-PF. And this is what politicians have to give to the people. Thank you for joining us, Joyce Mtsiabako. Yes, Tubelile Tubadewa, forward and forward chairman, full support. Thank you so much for the support. And I would also need to emphasize that Zimbabwe Adzoka has, Maibuye is Zimbabwe, Zimbabwe Adzoka has made some tremendous progress. Like I said, during the beginning, we have launched officially in 7 out of 10 provinces, but we are in 10 provinces and we have got teams in these provinces. And we have launched in Bulawayo province, we have also launched in Matabeleland South, and we have teams in Matabeleland North. And the only provinces that we haven't launched officially is Midlands and Mashonaland West. So we are looking that by February, we will finish launching in all these, officially launching in all these provinces, and our teams on ground are already doing some programs. But we ask for your support in the provinces where you are. Tell your neighbors, spread this message. The most important thing is that we preach unity, unity and unity. Let's debate about this unity. Let's debate about the configurations around this unity. Let's debate about the coalition. Let's debate about how it's going to be constituted. But tikabatana tinokunda. Unity is the only answer that we are going to have. So if we are to reclaim our country in 2018, we have to be united. We have to go there as a coalition, as a united front. So I'm coming close to the end of this broadcasting, and I will be happy to take some more questions regarding Zimbabwe Adzoka's work, our future work, or our position on different issues. And if we don't have so many questions, I will be very soon closing this this broadcasting. But I am so humbled to chair Zimbabwe Adzoka, and what we have managed to achieve in a space of 5 months, 4 to 5 months, it's very amazing. And I need to thank you, comrades on ground, the work that we are doing as Zimbabwe Adzoka. Let's continue to do that. Let's continue to preach unity. We encourage you to support Zimbabwe Adzoka, but we also encourage you to support other citizens' movement. This is not about Zimbabwe Adzoka. This is not about this flag. This is not about Tajamuka. This is about Zimbabweans. Let's be united. Let's speak with one voice. Okay? Because it's only when we speak with one voice that we can reclaim our country back. What binds us together is greater than what separates us. We have so many issues to discuss as a nation. We have got so many things that needs to be addressed in a new Zimbabwe. We have got so many, questions that we want to be answered in a new Zimbabwe. But I think the beginning is to reclaim our country back. Lindsay Machona Mayanzanise, I love what you guys are doing and have always been in support of a strategy. We need our Zimbabwe back. Thank you so much, Sister Lindsay. Continue to support Zimbabwe Adzoka. Maibuye Zimbabwe Adzoka. Zimbabwe Adzoka will never leave the corner of the oppressed. Zimbabwe Adzoka will continue to fight in the corner of the Lumpen proletariat. Zimbabwe Adzoka will continue to fight in the corner of the peasant. Zimbabwe Adzoka will continue to give voice to the Lumpen proletariat, to the peasant, because power lies within the people. And this is what our politicians don't appreciate, and this is what we have what we need to show them. So as we move towards the elections, talk to your neighbors. You have got in your area where you live, you have got millennials that you know. Ask them if they have registered to vote. Campaign, election campaign, when it's citizen driven, it does not have a date. We cannot say that we are starting to campaign in March or April as politicians. Citizens' movement, as citizens, we campaign every day. At work, let's talk unity. At schools, let's talk unity. We need to be united. In colleges, let's talk unity. Mlungis Dube, thank you for joining. You have joined to the tail end of my broadcasting, and I need to thank you. I need to thank you, those who have joined this live broadcasting. Let's continue to debate about these fundamentals, but let's talk unity for our country. Let's support citizens' movement, because citizens' movement, it's you and me. Citizens' movement, it's you and me. Let's define the type of country that you and I want. And let's not wait for politicians to tell us what to do. Let's not wait for politicians to tell us the Zimbabwe they want. Let's tell them the Zimbabwe that we want. We have seen in 2016 that this is possible. Let's continue to push this. Let's continue to push this until 2018. Let's have Zimbabwe in our hands. Let's start to work with the Zimbabwe that we want. Okay? And let's speak unity. Let's speak unity. I urge you, Zimbabwe Adzoka. I urge you, Maibuye Zimbabwe. Preach unity. Let's talk about a coalition, and let's bring our country back. I thank you so much, and wish you a prosperous new year. in activism term, 2017 is not going to be an easy year. It's going to be very, very difficult. And I encourage our foot soldiers on ground that we need to keep pushing. Zimbabweans in the diaspora, I beg you, can you please plug in and help our foot soldiers on ground? They are operating under very, very, very difficult circumstances. But you and I, if we are united, we are going to reclaim this country back, and we are not going to look back. As citizens, we are not going to disband our movements because we are going to reclaim Zimbabwe. It's just the beginning. Taking Zimbabwe is just the beginning from ZANU-PF. As citizens, we need to start to rebuild our country from 2018. Never again are we going as citizens to make that simple mistake of trusting our country to politicians only. Let's continue to speak out. Let's preach unity. Delina Mchambi, is the true Zimbabwe belongs to us as citizens. Yeah. Oh, so okay. So thank you, comrades. Thank you for tuning in to this live broadcast. I urge you to share this in different platforms. And I urge you to support not only Zimbabwe Yadzoka, but also other movements. But Zimbabwe Yadzoka is doing an important work, mobilizing in rural areas, the most dangerous places. We are also targeting the millennials. And so this is the type of work that needs your support so that we keep going. And wish you a prosperous 2017, and may God bless you all. Thank you so much. Praying for strength for 17, no matter how much it's going. Thank you so much, Delina. Yes, we need the prayers. And this time, it's going to be very possible. This time is going to be very possible. We have shown as Zimbabweans that we are united. And we are. When we are united, we are stronger beyond measure. Makomborero, thank you for joining, my brother. You have just come when I am about to close. But I think you'll get the opportunity to listen to this. But I also urge you, Makomborero from Zinasu, thank you so much for tuning in. What we are saying is that let's be united. Let's be united as Zimbabweans as we move into 2017. Our strength only lies in numbers. Politicians can only listen to us when we are united. And with these words, thank you so much. And let's pray for our country. Let's pray for our activists. Let's pray for 2017, and in 2018 our country is going to come back. Then we will celebrate and we will start to build our country. Thank you so much, my fellow citizens, and may God bless you. Thank you so much.